Hi everyone, welcome to data visualization with ggplot2 in R programming. In this lesson, I'll be telling you some of the fundamentals of ggplot2, and basically we will be also using here R 4.0. if you have not watched my previous videos on R programming, please do watch those videos. So you need to first search here kgp talkie R programming. There you will see the list of R programming videos. Basically, you have to first watch first and the second if you don't have a setup for R programming. In the first lesson, I have shown there how you can install R4 in your Anaconda. And thereafter, in the second video, I have shown there how you can use R programming in a Jupyter notebook. And the same thing we are doing here, we are using R programming in a Jupyter notebook. So you have to first understand what is the big idea behind the ggplot2. The ggplot2 comes from the grammar of graphics. There is the research paper for this grammar of graphics. You can visit and learn about more this ggplot. And when you program with the ggplot, whenever you plot the data with the ggplot, your plot starts with the ggplot. All right, it doesn't start with ggplot2, but it starts with the ggplot. And this ggplot is built up using the multiple functions connected with the plus signs. Moreover, when we call this ggplot doesn't actually plot anything. It just creates the outlines of a plot. It just creates there a figure canvas there. Thereafter, we add the component in that canvas. It's like you have a canvas, and then in that canvas, you want to add the components, like you want to add there the axis, you want to add there the color, lines, or any other types of the plot. So there is the plus sign. With that plus sign, we keep adding those components in the ggplot2 canvas. All right, you can add these components, like you can add the color, size, the fill, line, etc., all those things. These are the, you can say it's like a general syntax for a ggplot. Whenever we use a ggplot, we will be using there a ggplot. Then there will be a data set, there will be aesthetics. In the aesthetics, we will be having there the axis values. Then there is geom, all right. So this geom point is there, this geom. These things are adding the values, or you can say these are like adding the actual component of a figure in a ggplot. You have here a list of these component. You just click on there, you will be getting here these complete list. That's mean when you are, it is written there geom something, that's mean it mean to add any of these functions. You can add one or more than one functions together. If you want to plot their bar plot, use these geom. If you want to plot the box plot, use these geom. If you want to plot any other types of the plot, you can use other geom there. These are just plots. Thereafter, you have the positioning statements, like something this. You have annotation, you have aesthetics control, you have scaling controls. Thereafter, you have these guides, like the axis, legends, etc. So these things can be added by using these plus sign. In the later tutorial, I'll be showing you how you can do. All right, so let's go ahead and see what are the libraries which we are going to use. We are going to use here ggplot, lubridate, tidyverse, and there is ggalt, and this ggalt will be used for dumbbell plot. There is ggalley. This ggalley will be used there is scatter matrix plot. Thereafter, we have here ggrids that will be used, ggridge. So this one will be used for a ridge plot. Once you install it, let's go ahead and run it. I'm just specifying here the library path, just run it. So I have already installed. If you have not installed it, this is going to install some packages in your library, and I have already defined there a library path, so it's going to install all those packages in this library. Thereafter, you need to read the data set. So I'm going to read here the COVID-19 data set. So this data set I already have in my let me show you this data set. So here this data set is here. There you will see, there you will get this data set. So I'm going to read this one, COVID-19 data clean version. Alright, so that one I'm gonna just read it. Otherwise, you can also get this COVID data from my GitHub profile. There you will get it at my Lakshmi Merit. Alright, so github.com/Lakshmi Merit. It will open here my profile on the GitHub. Go in repository. There you will have COVID-19 pre-process data. In the pre-process, there you have COVID-19 data clean version. Alright. So that's what file I'm gonna use here. This one. Thereafter, just read it. There I'm gonna read it. It says that this one is not found. It is because these libraries are actually not loaded yet. So we need to first load these libraries. So I'm just gonna copy it from there and then I'm gonna put it here, and then these has to be like library. You type their library and hit the tab there, then you will be getting these things. All right there you will get it. You need to just put all those things there so that you can include all these packages. Just run it. Alright, so it says that, okay, these are some conflicting, but don't worry about that. It will automatically resolve those conflicts. Just rerun it once again, and all these libraries are loaded. Just run it. So why I wanted to this lubricate to use? I wanted to lubricate. This one comes from lubridate, actually. This comes from lubridate, sorry. I said lubricate. This comes from lubridate. In this lubridate, we want to convert this. There is a column which is known as the date column, and that date column is not properly formatted, so I wanted to format that date column there. All right so it's loading. It will show you in some time. Once this is formatted into date time, then I'm gonna get the data only for United States of the America. So I selected there, the country is US, and I'm going to select it by a subset. Thereafter, I'm going to create here this ggplot. Do you remember I told you that the syntax of a ggplot? There is a ggplot in which we will pass there a data and then aesthetics. In the aesthetics, we pass x-axis data, y-axis data, and if you want to pass there, you can pass the color, shape, etc. Alright, and you can also look more about the aesthetic. Just search here these aesthetics. So there you will get this aesthetic. Open it into a new tab, and in the new tab you will get this whole detail. So these are the inputs for these aesthetics. Alright, there you have a lot more example about the aesthetics. Alright, super. So there you have this aesthetic. So we get there a default ggplot. This ggplot doesn't plot anything. It is just adding the data in a blank plot. Thereafter, I'm getting the latest data from here. And this one is the latest data. Let's go ahead and run it. And thereafter, this latest is there. I'm going to actually sort this latest into a descending order. And then I'm going to get here this top 10 countries. These are the top 10 countries which have a maximum COVID cases. These top 10 countries are US, India, Brazil, Russia, France, United Kingdom, Italy, Turkey, Spain, and Argentina. So these are the top 10 countries. Thereafter, I'm gonna just put here these are actually the indexes name, index name. So in this index name, I'm gonna put this vector there, and thereafter, these are the top 10. And thereafter, you are gonna just run it here. So it's gonna get these top 10 countries in the country vector, and there is edge vector country, class is vector country. All right. So when we check that whether this country is a vector or not, it says that yes, this is a vector, and class of country, that's mean the data types in between that is character data type. Alright, now I'm gonna show you how you can do a bar plot for top 10 worst hit countries due to the COVID-19. So there, I'm gonna pass there a top 10 aesthetics I'm gonna pass. Then this one is going to create a empty plot for the ggplot. But there is a plus sign. So with this plus sign, I'm gonna add these bar plots. So geom column is a kind of bar plot. Then color says that it's gonna set here orange color for the plot, and the fill is also going to be the orange color. Let's go ahead and run it. So as soon as you run it, you will get this plot. And this plot says that US is having most number of cases. That's mean the height of this bar is quite high. And another country is India and then the Brazil. But one thing you may notice here is that these cases, these plots are not sorted out. We had top 10 countries cases. These were sorted, but these cases are not sorted. So we need to sort it. There is a method to sort it. We pass there x is equal to the reorder country then minus confirmed cases. So with this, it's going to sort this country and in the descending order. All right, just run it. Thereafter, once you run it, you will notice there you have got the highest country, the country which have highest number of cases at the first, and then the other lowest cases countries. All right, let's go ahead and see how you can change the ggplot title, subtitle and the captions. All right, so in this lecture you will notice that we will be using there the theme method. So with the theme method we will be changing the title, and we will be also changing the face like bold, italic and the plain text, etc. We'll be also changing the adjustment of the titles, subtitles and the captions. So these things we are going to cover here. So we have already seen this one. This one is going to create you a sorted output. Thereafter we are adding here a bar plot, and this one is the new. There this plus, after this plus you have their labs. In this labs we are adding the title. This title says that top 10 worst hit countries till 10th of December 2020. There is the subtitle and the caption. Just run it. So what it is going to do, it's going to add the title, subtitle and the caption. Alright, so once you run it, it has added here this title, subtitle and there is a caption. So this caption says that this data is taken from Johns Hopkins University. Alright, just let's go ahead and rerun this one. Once you rerun this one, you will notice this, we have just removed from there the caption, and there is one more difference. You may not notice that. If you notice, this one is labs there. All right, you run there, you get this labs, but there you have this GG title. All right, these things are the same what we had earlier. These two things are the same. We are just showing here different ways to show the titles and the subtitle. We don't have a caption. That's mean either we can use here labs method, or you can use here GG title method. So with the GG title method, you will be also able to get the same result, but we do not have the caption here. All right. So do you notice there is no Johns Hopkins University there? All right. Now let's go ahead and do the change title and the caption style, font size and the color and the faces. So I'm going to just show you how you can change the color faces. So till this, we have already analyzed our data. Let's go ahead and hit the enter so that we can make sure that this is another part of this lecture. So this part we have already seen how to add the title, subtitle and the caption. Now in this part, I'm going to show you how you can change the color of the title. So this one is going to be the color of the title. This one is the size and face says that it's going to be the bold faces. And similarly for the subtitle, you have this color, and for the caption, you have this color and the face. Let's go ahead and run it. So once you run it, you get this. Now do you notice there you have something like this there? But here you have a different font sizes, different font color, different font faces. That's how you can change the font color, faces and the types. Let's go ahead and change this text position. All right, so I'm going to just change this text position. All right, so we have seen till now, and in this theme which we had seen there, I'm just going to add here one parameter. And that parameter is here this H adjustment. That's mean the horizontal adjustment. So this is the horizontal adjustment. I'm going to just add it in all these three lines of the code. And other things are the same. Just run it. So once you run it, now you will notice that this one comes into a center. Earlier it was not in center, but now it comes into a center. If you change it, the adjustment to something else, if you set one, that's mean this one is the right adjusted. If you set it to zero, that's left adjusted. If you set it 0.5, then it's a center oriented. All right. Then these are the settings when we change the plot wise, but you may You may have some requirement where you want your settings for all the plot. All right, for all the plot, then you can use these default setting. So here I have a default setting for the theme. So I set here the width and the height of this width and the height of this plot, 14 by 10. There we have the theme, and I set there the theme base size is 20. That means it's gonna increase the size of these text data. Thereafter, I'm gonna set here all the title, subtitle, etc. should be center oriented. Thereafter, you have all these, you have already you already have learned these things. So I'm not gonna just explain these things, but I have just explained these things. Just run it. So once you run it, now you will notice that we have got the larger image size and better font size as we had earlier. There, do you see there? This size has been increased, this font size has been also increased. All right, there you have John Hopkins University. All right, so thereafter we are going to see how we can plot the scatter plot. But do remember, now we don't need to set these adjustment and the colors and other things. These things are already set by default, so those will be used already. Let's go ahead and set these color for active, recovered and death cases. And the same thing we already have, we are just gonna run it. All right, so as soon as we run it, it says that there, let me see here, it says that the caption is not found. Let me see. All right, here it says that caption not found. I'm just gonna delete that. All right, so once you run it, you will get something like this. All right, superb. So this one is the cases where it is just increasing. All right, and currently we have around the 16 million cases in the world due to the COVID. Let's go ahead and see the line plot with the COVID. All right, so let's go ahead and just run it. Once we run it, there we see it with the line plot, and in the line plot we are seeing there these things are increasing. All right, COVID cases are increasing. All right, let's go ahead and run this one. This is just another method to plot it, and we can just run it. This line method is another method to plot it, what we had seen earlier. And there you will notice there we are actually plotting the two plots together. We are plotting here confirmed cases and recovered cases together.